Screening for myofascial pain by physicians can improve the multidisciplinary approach of patients with lower urinary tract dysfunctions, dyspareunia, or chronic pelvic pain. And in this video, I will discuss the development of an easy, reproducible screening examination for physicians of the levator ani and obturator internus muscle. Hello, I'm Heidi Moosdorf, a pelvic physiotherapist and health scientist. And you're in the right place if you want to learn about the latest scientific research and news on the pelvic region. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel down below and hit the notification bell. You can also visit my website at pelvicnewschannel.com and subscribe to the email letter. Please watch the whole video, because in the end I'll give you my personal opinion and the clinical implications of this research. There are indications that myofascial pain contributes to types of lower urinary tract dysfunctions, chronic pelvic pain, and dyspareunia. And therefore it's important that the pelvic floor muscles are examined on myofascial pain, because pelvic physiotherapy could be a good treatment option if that's the case. However, a lot of physicians, well, they don't know how to examine the pelvic floor properly on myofascial pain, and that's the objective of the research that I'm going to discuss today. They wanted to develop an easy, quick screening examination of the obturator internus muscle and the levator ani muscle in women. The protocol was developed in three phases. In phase one, they did a systematic review on the assessment of the pelvic floor muscles and combined the items from this systematic review with clinical experience of physicians and women's health physiotherapists. And in the second phase, this protocol was reviewed by other physicians and adapted. And in the third phase, this protocol was tested on a simulated patient, so a woman who is used to being vaginally examined, and she gave her opinion, and accordingly the protocol was adapted again. So the protocol, which was the result of the third phase, was the research protocol. Well, when examining the pelvic floor, you use pressure. And they, of course, you want to standardize the pressure as well. Well, that's not an easy task. They did the first 16 patients with a pressure measurement tool, and then did an interim analysis and found that the pressure applied by the two physicians doing the examination was nearly the same. And for the patients, they learned what pressure is by palpating mid-thigh on the rectus femoris. And well, I think it's a bit like when you're cooking a steak and you want to test the firmness or the doneness of the steak by palpating the skin between the thumb and the index finger. Not all professionals are comfortable doing an internal investigation, and therefore they also researched if external points can give an indication of internal myofascial pain. The 5 points palpated externally are left and right sacroiliac, the left and right anterior superior iliac spine, and the pubic bone. With the anterior superior iliac spine, just medial from it, is the insertion of the iliacus muscle, and the pubic bone being the insertion of the rectus abdominis muscle. And for each of these 5 points, they could get a yes or a no, being a 0 or a 1. So in total, the maximum is 5 points and the minimum 0 points. And this was compared with the internal myofascial pain points. And the internal points were scored from 0 to 10, so 0 is no pain and 10 is extreme pain. And the cutoff point was 4. So 4 is the cutoff point. And they chose this because this is the cutoff point they use in their clinic. So if the score is higher, they want a full internal investigation. For this study, women of 18 years and older were included. Women, of course, who want or are willing to participate in the study. And women who are not able to lay comfortably in the research chair and with a cognitive impairment were not included. This research was performed by 4 examiners paired in 2. In total, 35 patients were included with a median age of 55, but ranging between 29 and 83 years. And all these women had some kind of urinary problems, and 25 had prolapse symptoms. None of the women had pelvic pain. There was high agreement between the examiners on the external points and a high correlation of the internal investigation. And when the external points were compared with the internal points, they found that if you only palpate the external points, you find about 70% of the internal myofascial pain points. It's of course, it's not 100%, but it might be an option for those physicians who do not do an internal investigation. This research is the first to show that a quick and easy internal investigation for myofascial pain points is reproducible. However, to test the robustness of this examination, more research is needed with different testers and more patients. And of course, another topic is that we need more evidence of the connection between myofascial pain and pelvic floor dysfunctions. And I'm really curious to know if this screening examination is reproducible in men as well, because we see a lot of male patients with chronic pelvic pain or lower urinary tract dysfunctions. And another option with this research is that we educate our colleagues for palpating the external side when they think there might be a myofascial internal problem. And for those of us who are working in a multidisciplinary setting, it can be interesting to discuss this research with your colleagues to improve checking for myofascial pain. And if myofascial pain points are found, those patients can be well treated by pelvic physiotherapists. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel down below, or subscribe to the newsletter at my blog, pelvicnewschannel.com. And I'm really curious to know what your experience with myofascial pain is and your relation with your physicians. So feel free to leave a comment down below. Well, I hope you liked this video and see you next time.